day,
a day that
throws all of us back to the history of our people, a day that reminds us how important our strength is, the strength against our enemies, the moral strength that connects us and keeps us united. And on this Holocaust Day, 75 years after the war and the greatest disaster of human history, hundreds of thousands of elderly, including Holocaust survivors, were left alone in their homes under the threat of a terrible pandemic. At this hour, millions of civilians are sitting in their homes, good civilians, that woke up one morning and found that their workplaces closed or went bankrupt. Others were sent on holiday without pay. Independent people are crushing, large companies are closing down, and doctors and nurses are managing a daily battle for human lives. People of Israel, we are standing in front of the medical, financial, and social crisis, the greatest that we've faced in the recent years. This crisis has hit us at a time when we're dealing with the greatest, deepest, and longest political crisis that the State of Israel has seen. Three election campaigns without a decision, with unprecedented incitement, three election campaigns in which neither side has decided. The sad truth is that an entire country is at stalemate under a temporary government and a temporary Knesset. Some wanted to continue and roll for more and more election campaigns and maybe feel right. Some preferred to win in politics than win the fight against coronavirus. Myself and my friends could not stand against it. We chose to maintain democracy and fight the coronavirus and its consequences. We chose to keep the freedom of expression, the media, and the rule of law. For that, we had to come out of our comfort zone and work from inside. Yes, we thought that it is better to beat the coronavirus than win on social networks. We thought that holding elections at a time when emergency services are evacuating elderly is irresponsible. Going to elections at a time where a million Israelis are unemployed is irresponsible. Going to elections during a time where grieving families cannot visit the graves of their loved ones is unacceptable. For me, knowing that the leaders think first and foremost on the civilians before their personal benefit has never changed and will never will change. This is what drove me to go into the political field, and this is what leads for me the decision to thrive for an emergency and unity government. Believe me, I've risked my life for this country under fire many times. Political threat, as great as it may be, does not drive me from the goal that I set for myself to be a loyal public servant of the people of Israel and the State of Israel. Because the civilians of this state are more important than its leaders. The destiny of this state is more important than its leaders. The future of the state is more important than its leaders. Me and my friends are here because we chose a national mission over a political mission. In the recent weeks, I've met and spoken with Prime Minister Netanyahu
dozens of times. We've reached agreements that will put us back in functioning government. Agreements that will enable a responsible dealing of the coronavirus crisis. Agreements that will allow us to ensure that the judicial system works freely, does its job, and that the rule of law is maintained. In the next 6 months, the government will focus on a shared leading of the national fight against the coronavirus crisis. For that, we will establish a coronavirus cabinet that will need to my regret, function for a long time. This forum, where all the relevant ministers and the best professionals will sit over one table. Together, we will supply the public with necessary information and a solution to the entire economy. We have great challenges in the fields of health, education, agriculture, and establishing the modern welfare system to these new conditions. We need to rebuild the trust of the people of Israel in the leadership, Jews, Druze, and Arabs, ultra-Orthodox, religious, and secular, women and men, all people of Israel, are waiting for us to work together for them, particularly at this time. And I expect from other partners to join and take part in this struggle. As I said, we have passed three election campaigns filled with hate and the conversation about this has become the reality that we're facing. This is the reality that we'll need to fix together. Everybody is talking about who made greater achievements under the agreement, but for me, the greatest achievement for this government is that unity will sink in and a national appeasement cabinet will work to promote peace between us. This is the most important thing at this time for the Israeli society. The decision was not simple, and it has many prices. I, for once, would have preferred a slim government. And about the bloc that I'm leading, I want to narrow down the number of ministries. And I can say frankly that both the Prime Minister and myself would have preferred a different government that will fulfill what we've promised to the public. Truth is that for 2 years and through three election campaigns, the public has made a different decision. Those who are angry, I respect them. Those who are disappointed, I respect them. And all the civilians of Israel, I love. I love those who voted for me and those who haven't. I will be the security minister. And when the day comes, I will be the prime minister of all of you, from right and from left. People of Israel need unity. The people of Israel need a function in government. The people of Israel need a balanced judicial system. And I will not let them down. I would like to thank all my partners that have enabled us to reach this point for the people of Israel. I would like to say that the Prime Minister Netanyahu, as well, has made a significant move on his part on the public and personal level. I know he also paid and pays prices for this move. He, like myself, needed to turn a political rival into a partner. I know how difficult this was for him, for the people of Israel. We've succeeded together to overcome the separation for the shared that we have, and I thank him for that. Starting tomorrow, we will promote the establishment of the government for the people of Israel and for the state of Israel. We will wish all of us that through unity and shared fight will be the route in which we will walk on together with success. Thank you very much.
We've just heard Blue and White Party leader Benny Gantz defend his decision to join a national unity government together with Benjamin Netanyahu, explaining his reasoning to those voters who voted for him, as he promised that he would not make this move, and then lay out what he hopes to achieve in this emergency government.